Hello guys, welcome back to Tutorials Point. We are in our video lecture discussing about application development for Android. Now, if you remember in the last one, we had seen some UI control. In this one, we would be seeing the edit text. So what is the edit text? When you see some input or some text that can be have some input. So it's something like this. You can enter the values over here. So edit text is basically an overlay over the text view. And it is editable in nature. The best part about edit text is that it is having some rich editing capabilities. By this, I mean that, like if you see over here, we are having three different type of edit text. One edit text is used, is showing some hint. One is having some text and the other is showing the data as for password, it's hidden, right? So now let's look at the attributes for the edit text. So the very first attribute being the ID, it's a unique name for the edit text. Then is the background. If you want to have some by default background or some image or some drawable as a background, then we use the background property. Then if you want to have some auto text, by auto text I mean that there should be some auto suggestion features or automatic spelling errors removed, so that then we use the auto text. Then for drawable, if you want some drawable or some icon or some image at the end of the text or at the bottom of the text, basically below the text, then we use the drawable bottom. Then we have the on click, in which we actually invoke the views, click, and like say if you want the on click of an edit text, user should be able to directly log in, though it is not recommended, but yes, it can also be done. Then is drawable, right? If you want something on the right of the text, some drawable, then we use this one. And the final being the text, if you want some text to be there in the edit text, you use this particular property. So let's see how do we actually get the edit text in our application. The very first step being using Android Studio to create a new application. And after this, you have to go to your main.xml file or the active_main.xml. In this XML file, include your edit text. Very simple. Just drag and drop it and you are done. Now what you do, you have to go to your main attribute.java, create the object of the edit text, and then from here you can either fetch the data that user has entered, or you can even set your own data. And after this, you run your application on the Android device and you are able to see the result. So now, let's see how do we actually add an edit text. So if this is my main.activity_main.xml, here I simply drag and drop an edit text. Such an edit text comes up. This is the ID of the edit text and these are all properties are there. You need not to worry about these properties. These would be covering up when we cover the Android Studio demo over there live. Now let's see how do we actually make a object of the edit text. So if you see over here, we have taken the object of the edit text and here we are fetching the edit text, and whatever the text the user has entered, we are showing it as a toast to the user. So I hope you would have got like how do we actually make the object of the edit text, how do we use the edit text. So this is all about edit text from our side. Now we would be taking you through a practical demo where we would be actually working on an edit text and would be performing some action for the edit text. So guys, welcome back again. Now as we have seen what is the edit text, what are the few properties of edit text, in this tutorial we would be learning how edit text actually works and how it looks like. So to get started, let's launch up our a project named as edit text demo, and in the edit text demo, let's open up our activity_main.xml. In the activity_main.xml, as you can see, in my case I have taken up three edit text. And what is the text view? We won't be working on text view, we would be looking at the edit text. Let's first run it on our machines and see what are the possible things that I'm getting right now. So this is my phone, I'm trying to run this application. So I run it on my phone. Now, when I start entering over here in the name field, I'm getting a problem that I'm entering my name and it's not giving proper result. So to go and delete the entire thing, then I start typing. Right? Now let me go to the next field. So I write over here. So you notice something, that in the second field when I started writing, the values were automatically deleted. There was nothing to be done. So this property of the edit text is known as a hint,
And the last and the final one is, it's a password. So we again have to delete this one, but this is a password. So let's see how we can get this name property and how we can use a hint property and how do we have different types of edit text. So this is my edit text. Now I go to my name edit text, and in the property, and I delete the text. So if you can see that the text has been replaced by a hint, and when I start writing in this one, I would be able to automatically delete it, and the user won't be needing to go and delete it again and again, saving his time and effort. Now I take up a phone and a number. I write hint as enter phone. In number I write enter age. Now let me see how it shows up on my mobile phone. So if you see, when I have taken for the number field, I'm getting a numeric keypad, whereas in these ones I'm getting a alphabetical or QWERTY keypad. So this is an advantage of Android, in which if you have chosen a num or something like that, then you would be able to have a numeric keypad, making it easier for the user to get his input. Now I write and try and enter my name over here. So it automatically got deleted. I was not required to delete it over here, right? So this is the property of hint for a edit text. The remaining property for edit text remains the same. We can even increase or decrease the size of the text that we are entering. We can even pass the gravity like where we want our text to be. Obviously the edit text is the editable, and then the properties like layout height and layout width can be changed according to our need. You can give a background like I had been giving it over here till now. So I give this one. So the password field has got a background which is an Android icon. So see, password field has got an icon which is a. In a similar way, we can go to our edit text over here. We can see the properties that we have been changing. There are properties like, you know, ID. I can change the ID. Like this is a password, right? So in spite of TextView3, I write it as password. PWD, let's use it. This will help me when I'm using this edit text in my Java file. Now what I'll do is, I'll simply go to my Java file and make few changes and see how can I access the edit text over there. So I would be accessing the edit text, the password edit text. The process remains the same as we did it in the text view. For edit text number 4, I am getting this one and I am setting the text as text is set from the Java file. Now I will be running my application and I will be seeing how it shows and what it shows on my screen. So if you can see that this edit text has automatically been edited, and I'm able to see such a screen designed by me. So this was about edit text. we are giving you a small assignment. The solution is already there in your application. This is our SMS screen that has been designed by us. We recommend you, if you can design such a screen, it would be a great learning experience for you. So guys, this was all about the EdTech from our side. Stay tuned as we take you across through the other views and controls in our Android for our Android application development.